Hello, lovelies.
Hi, everyone.
Welcome to our 6 o'clock live cooking show.
Boom. We actually cooking for y'all this time.
The real cooking.
Yes.
There's no Hello Fresh over here. Just me.
And me. Just exactly. So you know, I'm Marche.
I'm Mikki.
And we are going to be cooking Mikki's Fiesta mix for you guys.
So we're making a Fiesta meatloaf.
Mm-hmm.
And if you want to see it, here it
Stay
goes.
Stay tuned. All right, so what are the ingredients? What are we working with today?
Okay, so the ingredients for this Fiesta meatloaf is going to be some ground meat. Ritz crackers.
Brown sugar, babe.
Milk. A couple pans. Sweet cornbread mix. I don't use Jiffy. onion powder and garlic powder. Parsley flakes. Ground pepper. Black pepper, white wine vinegar, ketchup, and tomato sauce.
Ooh, we fancy.
Eggs, and a can of green beans.
Yes. All right.
So,
I'm gonna fix the lighting a little bit. We're a little too hot.
Okay, so yes, we're making my famous Fiesta meatloaf.
So how'd you come up with this meatloaf?
Oh, we forgot something. Get the corn.
Oh yeah, how do you silence this? I get the corn.
We forgot something to add, which is the
star attraction.
Fiesta mix.
We had to search far and wide to find this for you guys, so it's going to be delicious.
Okay. So you asked.
Yes. How'd you come up with this ingredient for this meatloaf?
Yes. So one day I decided to make some meatloaf, and I was being kind of lazy. So I didn't want to chop up my onions or bell peppers or anything. So I went to the produce section looking for the pre-chopped onions and everything. But I came across the Fiesta corn. So it has corn in here. It has corn and it has some onions, bell peppers, red peppers, and all that stuff. So I was like, I wonder how would that taste inside of meatloaf.
Boom.
So I took it home and I put it together and I came out with a good meal plan.
So, all right, and so what's the first thing we need to do?
So the first thing we need to do is open our ground meat.
Okay. I'll get some scissors and do that, or a knife.
Yes.
I'm gonna be her helper today, guys. So she's gonna be telling me what to do, and I'm like her little sous chef. Okay.
We're gonna be adding all of this into the big pan. There's no point in getting a bowl and swapping, dirty up the dishes. I don't like all that cleaning.
So we just to dump it in there?
Just dump it in there.
Let me wipe out the pan first. Cleanliness is next to godliness. And the pan was clean. It's just been sitting. And I didn't want no dust to end up on the stuff. Okay. So we'll make some room right here for ya. Boom.
So we're going to dump the meat in the pan.
One, two, three.
Wow. So we're going to season the meat, though, with some black pepper.
Okay. How much?
Okay, but before we season it, I like to get my hands into the meat.
Go for it.
I got to do that for
it. Okay. Oh, no, I do it.
So I want to talk her through it.
Okay. Exactly. All right.
And then I guess I'll add it because your hands are dirty now.
Thanks.
Okay, so I'm gonna add some black pepper.
Girl, how much black pepper does this take?
This is meat. You need some, this is gonna be pretty much the only seasoning.
I think our first live I said that,
the first seasoning was on.
Our show was sponsored by diabetes.
Okay, also, with that, see, this is, I'm going to crush up. Now, some people use bread, some people use crackers. I decided to use Ritz crackers.
You want to use a knife?
Oh, you got it. Oh, you got it. And what I do with the Ritz crackers, I don't know how many I'm going to use. I just know how much I want on my meat.
So you kind of eyeball it.
I eyeball everything. So right now I have 5. So I just crumple it up. Just like that. See how easy that is, you guys?
Looks like fun. It's like something that kids could do.
Kids could.
I think they would like doing that.
I'm gonna get 2 more, because I don't eat that many. So I use 7 Ritz crackers. Oh, preheat the oven for 350.
Okay, I can do that.
Also, we're gonna add 1 egg.
Okay.
Okay, I forgot. We're gonna need a can opener.
Oh,
a can opener.
I have one.
I forgot about a bowl. We do need a bowl.
How big of a bowl?
That little one. Just that little one right here. Well, the clear one.
Oh, like this?
Yeah. This is gonna do some mixing real quick.
Okay. There you go.
Let's open. I'm gonna have her open the tomato sauce.
All right. Yes, here we go.
Now, while we have that sitting here, I'm gonna make it right now. Why is it sitting here? Because I like to add some of my meatloaf sauce inside of the meatloaf, not just on top.
Oh, yes. Nice little twist.
Yes.
The lid. Sorry.
So I'm gonna make a little meatloaf. I mean, make a little sauce to add.
Perfect.
So I use tomato sauce, a little bit of parsley flakes.
Girl, you in this heavy.
That's my little bit.
You in this heavy hand, pepper. Y'all.
Pepper. Onion powder.
So how many seconds? Oh, you don't even do about
that? Not too. I'm gonna say a tablespoon of each one.
Okay.
A teaspoon. Teaspoon, not a tablespoon. A teaspoon of each one.
Okay.
And she's gonna mix. She's gonna mix it. Okay. Will she? Or she's gonna mix it.
Yes. Yes, I am. Smell.
Oh, and a little bit of the white wine vinegar.
Okay. There you go.
Mix that, ma'am.
All right. I'm getting all the tomato sauce on my arm, y'all.
So my hands about to get really, really dirty.
Or you want me to do the dirty stuff?
If you want to get dirty, I have nails, so you know what? You can get dirty.
Okay.
Okay, so she's about to add the sauce to the meat for now.
And then I'm gonna mix it all together.
You are.
Is it time or it
doesn't? No, you're gonna mix it. You're gonna mix it right now.
Okay. Sounds good to me.
You don't need all of it. We're gonna add more to this.
Oh.
We're gonna add more to that.
She's like, after you're done putting it all in there, we don't need all of it. Okay.
So just mix it all together.
Like this.
Yes.
Okay.
And while she's mixing it all together. I'm going to add some of the corn, Fiesta corn mix to it.
I have never made a meatloaf from scratch before, so this is
Very fun.
So I eye everything. I just know how much I want on the inside, and you would never know unless you just eye it. So. But I want some more onions. Okay.
So you kind of pick and choose what you want to go in there.
Yeah. Let me mix it a little bit more.
Okay.
So when you're mixing the meatloaf, fold it in. Try not to pack it together. You want it to be fluffy. So do not pack the all the ingredients together. So Marche, just fold it.
Okay.
Fold it. Because you want it to stay like not clumped together. You want it to be together though. So you want it together, but not like packed like a meat patty. You don't want
it. Oh, you don't want it in a meat patty.
No, but you want it together. Like the size of a meatloaf, but just together.
So you want me to spread this out then?
No, I'm spread it out. So I'm gonna dig in.
There you go.
Okay. So I add enough corn. So what I'm gonna do is fold it all together. And I'm gonna turn it the long way.
Oh, it actually looks like a loaf. It's like a whole loaf right now. Let's see who's on. Darrell. Hi, Darrell.
Hello,
Darrell. I wonder how this is going to taste. Looks like she knows what she's doing. I know, I'm excited.
Who said
that? Darrell.
Oh, Darrell said that.
Yeah.
I do know what I'm doing, Darrell. I don't know if you know. Like I said, don't pack it together. Because you want your meat to, I don't say breathe when it's cooking. Because sometimes you have your meatloaf and it's hard to cut through it. So if you pack it together and it's time to cut it when after it's finished, it's like hard. But if you like keep it kind of fluffy while it's cooking, it'll cook, you know, fluffy like. And you just cut it easier.
Okay, okay.
Anyway, so it looks together to me.
Mm-hmm.
Looks fine to me. I can see the corn in the areas that I want it. Next, we are going to get the bowl again.
Okay.
Make sure I got everything. Oh. Put some more tomato sauce in the little bowl. Not too much this time. Just a little bit. Because we're going to... A little bit more. That's enough.
Okay.
We're going to go back and use the ketchup this time.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
We're going to add a lot of ketchup to the bowl. All
right.
It's new, so you gotta take
it. Yeah, take it out. I was just guessing because I was like, I've been had before by these containers. Okay.
Yeah, we're gonna wipe on quite a bit of that.
Yeah.
More? Yes, enough.
Okay.
Okay, then we're gonna add some brown sugar to that mix.
Okay. Ooh, it looks like it's gonna be sweet. How much brown sugar?
We're gonna eye this.
All right.
I think that's enough. I think. But it's enough.
They be having some big old chunks up in here too. Okay.
Okay, so we're gonna add the same stuff to that. The white wine vinegar.
Okay.
The black pepper. We're gonna add the onion powder, and we're gonna add the garlic powder to that.
Do you wanna add that since you eyeball it, or are you gonna tell me when to stop?
I want you to do it. Well, I'm telling you when to stop.
Okay.
Stop. Ooh, that was a lot. Yeah. Talk about me.
Well,
okay, stop. And some parsley flakes.
Okay.
Ooh. It doesn't matter on that. Let's keep going. Keep going. All right. And then mix it.
Okay. I'm gonna say you can. You can keep your hands dirty so you can put it on there.
Yeah. Well, in case I need to use my hands, because I don't want to get them washing.
Right. Exactly. Mm-hmm. All right.
Oh, actually, you can do it. Okay. So. That was quick, as you can see. How long have we been on? It's only been about 10 minutes.
Yeah.
So that was quick when we put everything together. Now I'm going to have her add the tomato paste sauce.
Yeah.
Whatever you want to call it. meatloaf sauce on top.
Okay.
Before we cook it.
How do I put on there? Like long ways or just like this?
Just like that. Would you just like that.
Do I keep it in the middle or do you want me to spread out?
We're gonna make some more. So that's enough.
Okay. So you really just like kind of rub it around it, right? Like make it an even coat.
We use the spoon.
There you go. Do you want me to make some more?
You can. We'll make it later.
Oh, okay.
I'm gonna make some more later.
Very cool. Very cool.
Yeah. Yeah. So let's see.
Okay.
Okay.
That's good.
Smells good already.
It does smell good, y'all. I wish you guys could smell it. Do you smell
what I'm cooking? Now before we put it in the oven, it looks like this. But it's gonna look even better in a minute.
It looks pretty.
So we're gonna put it in the oven for about
45.
20 to 30 minutes for now. And then we're gonna check on it and then do something else to it.
Okay.
Okay.
Yay. So guys, how was your day? Did you guys have a good day?
Oh, Marcia.
I did.
I thought you were gonna open it. Oh,
no. I'm gonna open it.
Okay, stop. Alright.
Okay. Oh,
that's
full.
Do
you put full on?
Yeah. We're coming. Alright, I'll do it with some cup.
Yeah, I'll put full on real quick.
Okay. All right, so we're gonna let that cook for about 20 to 30 minutes, and then we're gonna check on it and add a few more items to the top, and then let it cook for the rest of the time. So like Marche was saying, how have you guys' days been today? I know it's been kind of cloudy lately.
Yeah, well, what did you do today?
Nothing. No. So as you know, I work nights, so I don't do much during the day. So I didn't do much today.
Well, my cat Franklin got a new litter box today. So I spent the day assembling that and putting that together, and it has been a little bit of a mess. So do you want to make the cornbread now or do you want to wait? Let's wait.
We can wait.
Okay.
Yes.
So, in the meantime, guys, we are going to play a trivia game. See if you guys know your stuff. So, if you guys want to play the trivia game, right in there. Hey, Michael, I see you're on here. If you guys want to play this trivia game with us, then I guess right in there, I want to play. And then we will start your trivia. We'll tell you the categories and we'll do it. But for right now, I'm going to quiz Mikki here. So what category do you want? We have pop culture, we have the 90s, we have great literature, we have general knowledge. What topic?
Okay, so.
Ooh, black history. If we did black history, you think people's black cards would get taken away? I'd be embarrassed. I'd be so embarrassed if I got my black history ones wrong.
I'm gonna go with, dang, I just feel like I'm not gonna do good. So
do you want to do me then? Do you want to just quiz me maybe? Funny people, girls from the world. Ooh, Netflix and chill.
Go to Netflix and chill.
All right, yes. Yeah, since Mikki's the queen of Netflix, let's see.
I'm not the queen, but
you like you some Netflix. All right, you ready?
Ooh.
What animal has a key role in the series premiere of Black Mirror? A pig, a cow, or a horse?
Pig.
Okay. You got it! Come on, Netflix. Okay. What famous mean girl inspired Jen in To All the Boys I've Loved Before? Katie Heron, Regina George, or Gretchen Wieners? Oh, Jen in To All the Boys I've Loved. It was Regina George, by the way. I had no idea. I don't watch the show. Okay. Where is Orange is the New Black's Red originally from? You know, Red the character. Russia, Slovenia, Slovakia.
I'm gonna say Russia.
You're right.
Okay.
Netflix. Okay.
Okay, where is Stephen Avery from? Appleton, Wisconsin, Ann Arbor, Michigan, Manitowoc County, Wisconsin?
Manitowoc.
Okay. Yes! Are you guessing?
She's guessing, y'all. She doesn't know these.
Okay. What is the most watched Netflix show? The Office, Friends, or Parks and Recreation?
Friends.
It was The Office.
I've never seen it.
Well, it's not on anymore. All right, here we go. What was the original name and setting of Stranger Things? The Hamptons, Manhattan, or Montauk?
Montauk.
It was right! Jeez, y'all, she's a good guesser. Okay, who was the first person cast on The Office? BJ Novak, Steve Carell, or Rainn Wilson?
Steve.
It was BJ Novak. I didn't know that.
Mm-hmm.
What was the original name of Netflix? Beneful, Alpo, or Kibble?
Is it Kibble?
Let's see. It was! How did you know?
I've heard of that.
Who almost bought Netflix? Blockbuster, Google, or Amazon?
Google.
Blockbuster. They should have bought it. They wouldn't have gone out of business. How many people still get DVDs from Netflix? 1 million, 1,000, or 2.7 million?
Now?
I guess.
1 million.
2.7 million. That's a lot of people. All right. Good job, Mikki. Hey, guys, it just got on. We have Rosie. If you guys want to play trivia, we can just put in there, I do, and then we'll quiz you. But until then, we're going to be doing trivia on each other.
And in case you don't know, we just finished prepping some Fiesta Corn meatloaf. And right now, we have it in the oven.
Yes.
We're going to wait a little bit, and then we're going to prep the cornbread, and then we'll cook the green beans at the end.
Yes, yes. Okay, so I want to do something, and I need you to sing. I want to do a song. Oh, finish the song lyric, and I want you have to sing it for me. Here you go. It's this one. Finish the song lyric.
Push play?
Yep. And right here.
Oh, as long as I know how to love, I know I'll stay
alive.
Of course.
Oh, as long as I know how to love, I know I'll stay alive.
Okay, I've got sunshine on a cloudy day. When it's cold outside, I got the month of
May.
Duh.
I guess you say what can me. Okay.
You see me do me dirt. You see me do me dirt. Dirt, 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 dirt.
You see me work. Do me work.
Work? No, dirt.
Ah! I never heard that song.
I'm like, anyway. Under my
umbrella, Ella, Ella.
All right, Rihanna.
I
only call you when it's half past.
I only call you when it's half past five.
The okay. Weekend. Okay.
Yeah, that's the hills.
Yeah,
by the weekend.
Of course.
Woo! So far, so good.
I'm off the blank end. Watch as I dive in.
I'm off the deep end.
That's Usher, right?
I think so. Yeah.
Lately, I've been thinking I want you to be.
Lately, I've been
thinking I want you to be happier. Missing me or here?
Maybe here.
Maybe here.
Happier. See, I don't know some of these songs.
I got broads in
Atlanta.
Cali. Okay.
You do?
I say.
Speak on it. No.
I got broads. That's
I got broads in Atlanta.
Yeah, yeah, future. Mm-hmm. You and me are. So go all you can. So go all you can eat. Fill up your bag and I fill up a
thrifty.
Plate.
You and me are thrifty. That's Ed Sheeran.
What?
I'm in love with the shape of you.
My peanut butter chocolate cake with your kiss, milk, or Kool-Aid?
Milk?
Kool-Aid.
What song is that? All right. Well, that sucks. But speaking of music,
okay,
I don't know if you guys
are big Nicki Minaj fans, but I am. So Nicki Minaj on Friday just dropped.
Hello, Tracy. Thanks for joining our live.
Yeah.
I want to say show, but that's not until
June 6th.
So tune in. Yes. Back to Shay.
So Nicki Minaj just dropped her album on Friday, and it was a re-release for Beam Me Up Scotty. Are you a Nicki Minaj fan?
I like Nicki.
Did you hear any of her mixtape stuff?
No.
So she went live and she was like, I'm going to upload my mixtape. And everybody was like, oh my God, I'm a Nicki Minaj fan. So I was really excited about that. She released 3 songs that I have not heard yet. So do you want to listen to those songs real quick?
Y'all want to listen to them songs real quick?
Anybody? All right.
Would it be on? I can, well.
You want to play on your phone?
Yeah, I can play it real quick.
I only call you when it's half past. Fuck the only time that.
Hello, Tracy. Might, you said might as well. Well, thanks for tuning in this go around. How was your day? So which one is it?
So the album's called Beam Me Up Scotty.
Okay.
And here we go. Beam Me Up Sky. Boom, here it is. But her new songs. Okay, here we go. Seeing Green, Fractions. I heard Fractions was one. And Crocodile Remix. Okay, you ready?
Mm-hmm.
All right, let's go. Hey Courtney, I'm good. That wine looks good. Why? What you get?
I got ice in it.
Why you got ice?
Because it wasn't cold. Yeah.
What are you doing?
I'm another viewer. Oh, so that was both. But yeah, so the wine wasn't cold, so I added ice.
Y'all, it's the Moscato Biasti. What do you think about it?
I like it. It's sweet. You should try it, Tracy. Whenever you get a chance, it's what you should try.
I'm gonna try it just to swear.
Yeah, it's pretty good. Like, it was sweet too, but it's
good. I told you, that's like the sweetest Moscato, the Biasti. That's like my mom's favorite one.
I need a refill.
This wasn't a taste. I said, Mikki, let me taste your wine, and then I poured this much. Tracy said, if it's sweet, I'm with it.
You know we like sweet, Tracy. Yep. So when I prep the cornbread, I don't like Jiffy. This is what I use. I do not like Jiffy. Everybody use Jiffy. I feel like when there's a trend of anything to eat, every black person eats the same thing. Like the grocery store doesn't have anything else. Well, since I'm not a follower. Shots. This is what I use. When I make my cornbread, I use this. Martha White's sweet yellow cornbread mix. This is what I use.
This is good.
Because I don't do chicken.
I wonder how long that cooks for.
So our meatloaf has been in there for about 10 minutes right now, guys. And you said that we need to check in 20 or 30.
22:30.
Okay. So, we want to tell people about some of the topics that we're going to talk about on our show.
Yes, so coming up in 2 weeks.
Let me turn
the music down.
Got some drama queens for real.
So coming up in 2 weeks, we are going to have our first talk show episode.
Yes. It's going to be on June 6th, and some of the topics that we have for you guys are going to be, why is it hard for a single man to date?
We'll have a male on the show.
Yes.
We don't know exactly what date or which episode he will be on, but he will be on the show.
We actually have more guy guests than girl guests.
We have more guy guests than female guests.
Yeah.
Correct.
So hopefully we can actually get some insight and really drill them about some stuff.
Exactly. That's the plan. So for you guys that think we are a male bashing talk show, we are not. We would love to hear your input, your thoughts.
Yes.
Your concerns. Whatever you gotta say, like, we don't mind. You see, we're giving our thoughts,
yeah.
We're not bashing you, man.
And one thing too that we're gonna do is one of the ones we're gonna do is called Can Women and Men Be Platonic Friends?
Yes, that will be a show also.
So I feel like a lot of people were like talking about that whenever that Steve Harvey clip came up.
Okay.
So I'm thinking that we're probably just gonna have to like see what our guest feels about that.
Exactly.
Do you have platonic friends?
I have platonic friends.
Okay. See, I don't have any platonic friends. I feel like all of my guy friends, like, I don't know. I think the door is just always open. They just are low key thinking that it might happen.
We'll let them keep thinking that. Keep your thoughts to yourself.
Period.
Your thoughts to yourself. Yeah. So yeah, we have quite a few topics coming up in the near future. We will not be cooking after next Tuesday.
Right.
No more cooking shows. FYI, no more cooking after next Tuesday. It's gonna be straight talk show.
Yes.
It will not just be us two talking. We will have guests. Mm-hmm. Every week you will see a different guest on the show. Mm-hmm. We will have a total of 8 shows.
Yes.
Meaning 8 guests. We will also collab with another podcast, and hopefully you will enjoy that also.
Yeah.
That's also soon to come. So don't forget go to YouTube and subscribe to our YouTube channel so you can get all of our notifications and know about all of our videos that's coming up. So that way you don't be behind. That way when we blow up another year or so, you'll be like, hold on, I was one of the first.
Exactly.
And that way we can shout out to you.
I'm just saying. The people that are watching the live are gonna be like, oh, my name is on their live.
From like over a year ago. Like I was the first one who commented and said, I know that's right. I'm just saying, like, it starts here.
Yes.
Today, right now, why not?
Period. Why not? I'm excited about this. I think I'm really excited because, like you said, like, years from now, we're going to look back at the topics that were here this year. And we actually might have a voice in it, you know? Next week for our cooking show, since it's going to be our last one, we are going to bring some guests on.
Yes.
So it's not just going to be us two over here cooking. Even though I know you love
chairs,
our beautiful faces.
We have booties in them. And we'll be our booties. We'll be cooking for,
yes,
2 guests. And they will let you guys know how the food turned out.
Period.
And next week, we will be making some
salmon.
Salmon.
Mm-hmm. So if you guys want to some good eats, then I would definitely tune in next week too. But I really like your recipe for today.
It's gonna be good. I hate you guys can't taste it. I'm telling you, like, you're gonna be like, next thing I'll be hearing, y'all taste that Fiesta Corn Meatloaf? And I'll be like, I wonder where that came from. Mm-hmm. I'm just saying, you can't always stick with your old grandma's routine or recipe.
Yeah.
And I know you, Tracy, you feel like meatloaf is a poor person's food.
Ooh.
You see all that mess I put in there?
This.
I spent a lot of money on that meatloaf. And I'm telling you, it's going to be good.
I've never heard that before.
What?
That meatloaf was a poor person's food.
I have.
Oh, really?
Yes, I have.
Well, they serve it at some restaurants, right?
They do.
I don't order it at a restaurant, but they do serve
it. I have ordered it, but you're right. You're right, they do serve it.
So I don't know. I guess a poor man's food would be like ramen to me.
Noodles?
Yeah. To me, that's like
poor person. It's poor, but good. Yeah.
I love ramen. They even have ramen restaurants.
See?
But you know, whenever you go to the grocery store, it's like 99 cents.
Yeah.
But yeah, I guess, yeah. What's something else you cook?
Although we're making a salmon next week from HelloFresh, mm-hmm. right? I make a mean salmon.
Who are you talking to when you say that? You're over here throwing Tracy, shots.
Oh, okay.
Tracy say, I was thinking about noodles too. That's the only thing I can think of when I hear poor man's food. It's like,
I understand Tracy, who made that comment, said that meatloaf was a poor person's food.
Oh,
so then he said also noodles. You're right about the noodles. That's just 99 cents, Tracy.
See, right there.
So yeah, you're right. So noodles, yeah.
I'm about to say, I've never tried to make meatloaf from scratch. But it feels like it's a lot that goes into it.
It's a lot.
Like, there's money that goes into meatloaf.
You hear that, Tracy? It's money that goes into meatloaf.
I mean,
it's not all scraps.
Yeah.
Who has scrap? Well, these are things you should already have in your kitchen.
Yes.
So, like,
this Fiesta Corn by itself is $3.50.
See?
So that's more than the ramen.
Right.
We gotta get three ramen noodle packs with this.
So
you're really good at meatloaf. What else are you really good at cooking?
I make a mean salmon. Although we're not cooking my salmon next week, I make a mean. I like my salmon kind of spicy because I like spicy food.
Mm.
So I make a mean, sweet and spicy salmon.
I didn't see that you were getting kind of heavy-handed with the
seasoning
for this meatloaf. I was like, girl, you said I just eyeball it, and then you talk about some two tablespoons. You said one tablespoon, and then you said one teaspoon, and I was like, oh, those are different things, people.
Also make a nice chili bean.
Oh, I like chili. Chili's delicious. Have you ever had Wendy's chili?
I have. It's
girl,
decent.
Their chili is all the girl.
Wendy's is
chili. I used to legit, like, in college, I used to eat Wendy's chili, like, once a day. And there was one right across the street from my dorm. And so I would walk across the street and I would, like, get my little chili, girl, every day. I could live off of Wendy's chili.
You could.
I loved it so much. So let me see. So I have some recipes that I make too. And you know, oh, girl. So, y'all, let's put a little background story up.
He said he had some Wendy's chilies last night.
See, Tracy? I told you, girl. It go hard.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It goes hard, Tracy. What did Chris say? There is something wrong with my food that has... Girl, you know I can't read.
Girl, a loaf in it, unless it's a bread.
Well, we put crackers in it. That's bread?
Yeah, it says, there is something wrong with any food that has the word loaf in it, unless it's bread.
also,
any food that has loaf in it, something wrong with it.
So, Chris is childish, is what we're saying.
I guess so. Until you try this meatloaf, I think you're just joshing us.
Yes.
Just talking.
It's good to see you, though, Chris. Oh, Tracy says we're reading her mind. Yes, we are. I'm telling you, sis.
It's a dude. Tell me it's a dude. He's like, I'm offended.
I'm sorry. You're right.
But
so do you cook any desserts?
I make a nice banana pudding.
Oh, really?
Yes.
I want some of this banana. Okay, so let's give y'all a little background story. I have hosted parties at my house, and this one here has came over and she has tasted my cooking. I have had all types of chickens and all types of stuff for my little parties. I push myself to try something new. But my best go-to meals, I make this mean lasagna, girl.
Okay.
My lasagna is bomb, girl. I also make a really good sopapilla cheesecake.
That sounds different.
Do you like cheesecakes?
I like strawberry. I never had any other flavor but strawberry.
So the thing about my sopapilla cheesecake is that it's actually warm. It's a warm cheesecake. So it is so savory and sweet. That's my duo. I love savory and sweet meals. So if I ever get to be a judge on MasterChef,
you know what? Although we're making salmon next week, I have a question for the two that is viewing right now. If you had a preference and you wanted to see us cook something, what would be your preference? What would be your food of choice for us to cook here live?
I'm trying to think about
it.
I would really like to see if we could cook a steak really well.
Steak?
Yeah. I know you don't eat steak.
I know. Yeah, something like
but
that.
But because with the steaks, you gotta like marinate that overnight. Like marinate it in like a batch of Coca-Cola.
Coke.
No, you put Coca-Cola in like a little bowl, and then you put the steaks in there, and it makes it really tender.
Okay.
It's almost like you're marinating it, and then you put it in the refrigerator, and literally anything you put on it, it just like melts in your mouth on top of tasting whatever you put on it.
You say steak, I think I would want to close to steak, make some a good brisket or a slab of ribs.
But you know how to grill?
No. So I'll be learning.
I don't know how to grill either. I be trying to learn. Like I be watching my dad. I be outside standing there. I be like, all right, dad. So you turn this over after how many minutes? Well, you kind of have to have a feeling. It's like a gut feeling. You just know. And I'm like, oh, okay. So I'm never gonna grill because I don't think I'm ever gonna have that gut feeling about grilling.
Okay.
What did Chris say?
Okay, salmon would be interesting. Only fish I have ever cooked was in stick form.
Fish sticks, yes, Chris. You're right.
Okay, so we are cooking salmon next week, and yeah. We'll see how it turns out.
Oh my God, I have the funniest story. So Chris probably knows about this, but because Chris lives in St. Louis, and so when
all right, Chris,
I was living in St. Louis for the last 7 years. I just moved back to Dallas a year ago, so I'm in the grocery store for the first time in my new place in St. Louis. And I'm like, I'm gonna make myself a steak, right? I'm out of my own, I'm in St. Louis, I'm gonna do this. Girl, I go to the grocery store. All the steaks were like $9.99. And they were these big steaks. I was like, where are steaks $9 at? In Texas, steaks are not $9. I was shook. I piled up, I was like, do you guys know they're $9 steaks back there? And everyone's like, yeah. I'm like, this is the craziest thing. I just came from Texas. I have never seen steak this cheap. But I go home. I literally put my I take my steak out the wrapper. I put it in the little Coke, right? Like when I marinate. I put it in the Coke, I put it in the freezer overnight. Girl, I was so excited to cook my steaks the next day. I said, oh, it's marinating. It's going to taste so good, right? Girl, I pulled out my steaks. I put my little Worcester sauce and my barbecue sauce, and I seasoned it really well with salt and pepper. And then I put it on my pan, like the skillet, to skillet fry it first before I put it in the oven. But it was cooking so fast. I was like, this is crazy. And the meat was like not red, it was like white when it cooked. And I was like, what is going on with this? But I didn't think too much about it. I was just like, well, maybe that's why I was on sale. Maybe it was some bad steak or something. So I was like, well, let me just go ahead and just try it. So put it in the skillet, then I put it in the oven. I made me some mashed potatoes, I made me some green beans, I made me some carrots. Baby, I brought that steak out, sat down at my table, got my knife, cut into it, bit into it, and it was so, like, chewy. But I was like, this don't taste like steak. Girl, I went to the trash can, pulled out the wrapper, and it was a pork steak. Yes, Chris, it was a pork steak. I was upset. I was like, dang, I've been had. I had never had a pork steak because in St. Louis, they don't do beef steaks. You know, beef. Okay. Their steaks come from pigs. Well, it's not necessary. They do have
cow steaks in St. Louis, but they're known for their pork steaks. And so when I went to the grocery store and I saw steak, I was just like, all steak is beef. All steak comes from a cow. St. Louis pork steaks. Yes, Chris, I told you so. I made myself a pork steak, girl. I was so upset. Because what their pork steaks do, they also shrink. So when you cook them, they're not as big as they look. They were like this big too. And I was just like, oh, this is some mess. But I wasn't. It wasn't what I wanted. Like, I really wanted a beef steak. Like, my mouth was sick. I told you, girl, I was happy. Girl, I was prepping all night. I said, I'm eating my steak tomorrow. It just tastes different.
Dance break.
Dance break. Y'all hear the music?
Oh, let me turn it up.
Go Mikki and Mikki.
And you gotta say, you gotta slow the Listen, them pork steaks upset me, Chris. I was so mad. I was just like, I grew to like them, but for me, that was just too much pork. Like, I'm not a big pork eater, like Aslan Malika. No, I'm not. I'm not Aslan Malika. But I was definitely feeling like, dang, now I know, you know, how, like, I feel like I was getting gout when I was eating. It was just so much pork. And, you know, normally I do like pork sausages or bacon for breakfast, but I normally don't eat pork for the rest of the day if I do pork. Chris, I miss you too. Oh, hey, Chris. Yes, yes, Chris. The beef steaks are where it's at.
It smells so good, you guys.
We put it in at 6:20, so it's been in for about 17 minutes, 18 minutes.
Smells like, I'm gonna add some more sauce to the top.
I'm gonna add
a little bit more sauce. So I'm gonna add my Hunt's tomato sauce, and of course I'm gonna add some ketchup. It's almost
all right. You ready for this? I'm bringing the meatloaf out.
You can
I'm gonna just put it on thing so it doesn't burn.
Okay.
Burn, baby, burn.
As you see, I everything. I everything.
Yeah, she's gonna try and put the measurements down for you guys in the description box so you can recreate this meal as well.
White wine vinegar again.
Yes, ma'am. So far.
Garlic and onion powder.
So far, guys, this is how it's looking. What you think, huh? Do we like it? Do we like how it looks so far? So far, guys, it's only been in there.
So far.
It's been in there for about 28 minutes. So we're going to add some more sauce. And then, yeah. This is going to be good. It smells delicious.
Smells very good. Very, very good.
Very, very delicious.
Now, it does have cracks in it. But I want cracks because I do not want it. I hate when it's packed together because when you cut it, I don't like hard meat. I like mine fluffy and soft.
Let's be clear.
It's going to be juicy.
Let's be clear.
It's going to be a juicy meat.
I prefer my meat hard at all times. Don't be coming up here with no soft meat.
Get it how you feel. I don't blame her.
Chris said, only way to do it.
I don't blame you guys. So, you know, got to be soft sometime. Yeah.
Not when they come over here. Will you be soft at your house? Let's be clear. Nah, I'm messing with you. This is a family show, guys. Oh, it's a week too. So our talk show is not raunchy, by the way.
It's not raunchy, no.
Mm-hmm. I feel like when we talk about women talk, sometimes people get like the idea that we're gonna be like talking about like our sexcapades or our hotels, meaning like what happened when we were single and we're out here getting it, party days at the club, you know, whatever, whatever. But it's not gonna be like that at all. We're really genuinely still trying to get men who want high caliber women to have some tips on what they can do to get them. And so that is what the goal of the show is.
So I believe that a lot of men think they know what women want.
Why do you say a lot of men?
Because I hear men talk and they you know how you go to the store, go to the club, go to a bar. The way men talk to you, they're talking to you like they know what you want. It's like they're trying to sell you what you want, and you're looking at them like, I don't want only that. Look, only that. But no, you're like,
I think,
you know, like what they're not doing is saying, I'm a good guy, I don't cheat, I'm loyal. They're not saying that. They're saying, I own this, I got this, I got that, I can do this for you, I can do that for you.
Yes,
so it's like,
yes.
What about the other stuff that I really want? So when a guy's not telling me I'm loyal, I don't cheat, I'm affectionate, I'm for you or whatever, then, you know, that's what women really want to hear. FYI, that's what we really want
to
hear.
Y'all listen to Mikki. Mikki's out here speaking some facts, okay? You hear me?
I'm just saying. That's what we really want to hear. Mm-hmm. But I'm not going to coach you and tell you to tell me you're not a cheater.
Period.
You should know to tell me. But that's if you're not one. I understand. So if a guy don't say that he's loyal and all these good things, it's because he know he's not. So I respect that too.
Right, exactly.
So when I choose to not talk to you, understand that's why. Because these are things that I need and that I want in a guy.
Come on, Mikki, with the tips. Now that's free.
That's free.
You got that without subscribing to YouTube. But if you want to get more tips, then you definitely go over to YouTube. It's in our about link. We're also gonna put it in the description for next week's too. You know what? We should probably copy and paste it in as a comment, so they can just click straight from the comments.
Yeah. And Chris said that you know, he was raised by a strong woman, his mom and grandmother.
Yes, Chris. Yes. Yeah. Chris is off the chain, man. We used to work together at City. Guess what, Chris? Mikki and I work together at Chase now.
I know that's right.
Yes, exactly. See?
So I'm topping this with parsley flakes. This is my last time. This is the last time this is going to go in the oven. So I'm putting all my toppings on it right now.
And you're just eyeballing that too?
I'm eyeballing it all. I'm going by how I want it to look. So when I say I eyeball stuff, I go by how I want it to look and what I think it's going to look like when it's finished. So I got my vision to what I want it to look like.
Yes!
And it looks right to me. Looks fine.
And this is Mikki's cooking show, so do what she say. Okay. Here, you want to use this? Is it too hot?
It's not too hot.
Okay, cool. I will open up the oven for you, ma'am. And how long is this going to be in for this time?
Another 15 to 20.
All right. I'll put on the timer.
Because look, the meat looks like it's really, really good.
Yeah.
At the bottom, yeah. So it's cooking really good.
Yeah.
That's also why I don't pack it, because it can cook quicker and...
It does cook quicker when it's not packed. I never even thought about that.
Packed, it can't cook.
Yeah.
I sometimes in the past I have to cut it to
let it breathe. Because you don't want that pink on the inside of no meatloaf.
And like I was telling her, so my mother said it's going to take over an hour for my meatloaf to cook. Mm. And I tried to explain, if you cook it correctly,
period,
it doesn't take that long to cook. So when I kept saying do not pack the meat in on the meatloaf, it leave it like fluffy, like it gives it space to breathe, and when it breathes it cooks faster or better. So when you pack it, the inside doesn't cook fast enough or evenly with the outside. So like I was telling her, we only have about a good 15 to 20 minutes left on the meatloaf, which is way less than an hour total. So I'm just saying.
Period. She was right, is what she's saying. I know that's right.
And I don't even cook like that. But I could use my dome and be like, this makes sense, and this is how we're gonna do it.
That's cute. That was really cute. I love that. And you know what? This is also a metaphor for relationships. If you pack it too close, if you are too smothered in relationships, it doesn't really fully marinate, breathe. You don't really get to know that person that well. But if you give yourself a little bit of space here and there, guess what? It's beautiful. It's done. It's quick. It tastes delicious.
Tastes delicious.
All right. So now we're going to cook the cornbread.
We are.
All right. And Mickey's going to walk me through how to cook her cornbread because, like what Mickey was saying, I'm one of them jiffy people. I felt the jab when she kept on saying jiffy. Okay.
You know,
okay. I said, she must have whooped in my pantry. And felt some way about it because, yes, I am a jiffy, you know, read the back of the thing when it comes to cornbread. Because I like jiffy cornbread. Especially put some butter on it. Baby, what?
So,
where's Tracy at?
He out there, I don't know. But I said what I said about the Jiffy because everyone uses Jiffy, right? To the point where I'm like, have you been to the grocery store? Have you seen all that stuff that they got on the aisle? Why are you limiting yourself to that item?
Well, it's because it's delicious. If I know Jiffy cornbread's delicious, I'm going to get what I know is delicious. Maybe we don't want to try anything new. No. We're all raised on Jiffy cornbread. Maybe.
I was raised on some cornbread. I wasn't sure what it was. So when I started cooking my own food, that's how I ended up using other ingredients and stuff because I never looked at what my parents or grandparents used. I just knew what they made.
Yeah.
I go to the store, I find the similar things and then put it together and I'm like, oh, this is just as good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I don't know what they used.
Yeah, you know, I think the cooking has definitely changed in the generations before. You know, a lot of people don't cook anymore. Mm-hmm. Moms and grandmas aren't teaching women and their men, like their sons, how to cook. But, yeah. Back in my parents' day, my mama and my daddy both.
Hello, Tracy. You spoke him up.
Hey, I like Jiffy, but I like Mickey cornbread too.
Okay, Tracy.
Okay, okay.
I know that's right.
Hey,
Tracy, what that cornbread be like? I'm just saying. No. So I'm gonna talk. Oh, a bowl so we can mix it. Yeah.
You can use that blue one if you want. Or how big do you want?
Not that big. But unless you want me to.
This one up here, maybe.
Okay, just one. So, yeah, just one.
Okay.
So, I would normally use two of these, but we're using one because it's just us two. And we don't want to overcook.
Right. We don't want to be wasteful.
We want to be wasteful, yeah.
All right. So, when we open this. Mm-hmm. Okay. Oh, and by the way, this is, for those who don't know, this is the... this type of cornbread that we're making right now. There she goes.
Martha White.
Mm-hmm.
Martha on some. I'm going to look her up to what else she got going on.
I know. I'm about to say, who is Martha? Okay. I know Martha Stewart.
Right, mate. But could it be? No, I don't know her. Her cousin? Her sister?
She is Caucasian too, so.
All right. I get it? Martha White.
Yeah.
Okay, we're gonna add that one egg and it said a half a cup of milk.
Okay. I have my, you wanna add the egg? I got my,
I can do that.
Measuring cups right over here. And we said half a cup of milk. Okay, okay. Beautiful. Beautiful done. And she said half a cup of milk. So that's what I'm doing. Look at that.
And we're gonna mix it up with the fork.
Fork, okay.
We're also gonna spray the pan.
The pan is still in the pantry. I didn't take that out. This is already looking like cornbread. We haven't even baked it yet. And that's all right. Come on, Martha White. She said Jiffy who? Well, maybe if Tracy's really nice to you, then maybe you can bring him over some of your cornbread since he likes it so much.
Tracy wants some cornbread.
That makes me think of the movie Life.
I don't want no meatloaf because that's poor people food.
Ooh, that reminds me of that movie Life.
You eat all your cornbread.
Yes.
That movie.
Live, you know Casey and JoJo.
I love hearing them two together singing.
Did you see their Tom Joyner morning show when they sing live and everyone was making fun because they didn't have the music behind it and they was going to church?
No.
Oh my gosh!
I do. I'll take a plate.
Hey, there you go, baby. How's this look?
Okay, so what are we gonna do? There I wanna go. See how consistency of it.
Okay, because baby, when I watched that Tom Jordan Morning interview, well, it was like a concert. Casey and JoJo were in studio with Tom Jordan Morning Show. Like, oh, it's the Tom Jordan Morning Show. And they started singing, but you couldn't hear the music. You could just hear them singing because okay. The music was in their headphones. And when that song came on, they said, oh, and it was like, oh, time is slipping away from me. And they were going to church in the studio and at you have got to see that clip. It was so funny. For the longest time, I played that. Like, so you know what? Now listen, before TikTok, we had nothing but funny videos on YouTube to watch all the time. We had Vine too, but man oh man, I used to sit there and I used to watch the same videos over and over again. That was one of the videos that I would watch to like get happy and like laugh. Because okay. They were just like, and there's no music. So you hear all their vibrato in their voice and they just like going to church. It's good. So if you guys have not seen the Tom Jordan Morning Show with Casey and JoJo, I suggest you watch it.
So I've already pre-sprayed the pan.
I love how you're going to make up a new word for spray the can.
Spray the can. And now I'm about to pour my Martha White's yellow sweet cornbread mix into the pre-sprayed pan.
That is so good, girl.
Oh, I didn't get that look too good.
Yeah, just don't put that in there.
Yeah.
Let's see. We got about 12 and a half minutes left on the meatloaf. We are making cornbread right now. And another side, we're gonna make our green beans. Do you guys have any good green bean recipes? I know a lot of people just like get the can like we do and like just season it a little bit. But I recently saw a YouTube video about people who do it like on the stovetop and they add all these types of spices to it and stuff. And I was just like, okay, maybe we can try to do something a little more fancy this time. Just try all the mixes together and see. And see what happens. Before it goes in the oven. So you ready for it to go in? What temperature is this supposed to be on? Does it matter?
That's a good question.
It probably doesn't matter.
Wait, we have to read the back of the bag. You know how we do. 400.
Okay.
So it's already on 300.
Mm-hmm.
So it's gonna be on 400.
Maybe we can put it in just a little bit longer.
Yeah, probably so. Yeah. I'm going to watch it anyway.
Yeah. Sounds like a plan to me. All right. And like I was saying, the green beans are kind of not really that hard to cook. A lot of people microwave them. I know I do. And then I season them after I'm done with them. Like, I don't... But I was telling them I saw this YouTube video about this lady who actually added like spices to hers and she cooked it stovetop.
I cook my stovetop.
Okay.
I add salt and pepper. I make it to where I like. So whatever it is I cook, I'll make it how I like.
Okay.
Matters what how's I already made, I add or subtract. You can't subtract. I add to make it no better.
So how are we gonna cook the green beans today?
We're gonna add.
Alright, so
because it says the green beans we have, it says no salt added. So we're gonna add salt and most likely pepper.
Okay. So while everything is in the oven, we are going to take this to the stovetop. Or at least you can't put this in the pan, show them guys the pan and then take it over there and cook it all.
The pot or
you use this one or you use the pot?
The small pot.
Okay.
Do you have a small pot?
See.
So I've been drinking this stuff, right?
How do you feel?
I think it's catching up with me.
This is the only pot that I have, the big pot. Because the other pot was when we used the rice for last time, and I had to throw it out because we burned the bottom of the pot. So which one do you want to use?
The pot.
Okay.
This is brown.
All right, so we're gonna just put the green beans in.
Just toss them in.
Okay.
What is that?
I think that's a little thing. Have y'all ever seen these little cones in y'all green beans?
It's my first time seeing that in my green beans. But yeah, I've never seen it before. Interesting.
All right.
Then we put the green beans in a pot.
You put any salt and pepper?
Yeah.
Okay.
Add a little pepper. Pepper. And she's getting the salt.
Yes. And I guess you stop when you want to stop, sweet girl.
You know how I do. And not too much salt, though.
Because we are not sponsored by diabetes anymore.
Not anymore.
They canceled their subscription after the last video. All right. Then what?
Okay, so we're almost finished, you guys. The meatloaf is almost finished. Well, now we're just going to wait on the cornbread. When the cornbread finishes, the meatloaf should be done. Okay. So it should be finishing together. We'll put this on like the last 5 minutes.
It
takes no time.
Like 8 minutes until the meatloaf is done.
Okay. We'll cook the meatloaf. Okay, so when I cook my meatloaf, you see how I added the meatloaf sauce on top?
Mm-hmm.
I stop cooking my meatloaf when the sauce on top is almost not hard, but it doesn't rub off on your finger. You touch it and it's on your finger, then it's not completely finished. I don't want it to be on my finger when I touch it.
Okay.
So
that's a good rule of thumb.
Yeah. That's how I know it's done. Or I feel it's done.
Mm-hmm. Oh, you know what? I can put the music back on. I like that one song. I really hope that Itty Bitty Petey comes on so I can freestyle for you guys, because I know all the words to that song.
What song?
Itty Bitty Piggy. You want to just play it?
Just play it, yeah.
Okay.
So guys, once again, don't forget to tune in to our subscribe to our YouTube channel that will be starting up. We already have the YouTube channel now, so you can subscribe now.
Mm-hmm.
But we'll start our episodes next month. The first episode will drop on the 6th of June.
I'm excited.
So tune in or watch it, like it, but subscribe first. So you can subscribe today.
Yes.
You don't have to wait. You can do it today. It won't cost you a dime.
Mm-hmm.
We're not trying to sell you anything.
Nope.
We're not trying to help you come anywhere. Just join, subscribe, and watch and enjoy. And please comment. We love any type of constructive criticism on how we can make things better, or any type of input. Or if you'd like to be on our show. Are you ready?
I was on the plane with Dwayne. You can call me Vicky or go to hell, man. Listen, I'm the baddest in the school, the baddest in the game. Excuse me, honey, ain't nobody in my lap. When you was in New York, you was a Yankee. I was with bass, I was kicking the Frankie.
You did this so cranky.
Gave him a hanky, cause mama, I'm cold. Flyer than a kite, I get higher than Rapunzel.
Okay, sorry.
I told them all the words of the song. I am a Mikki fan, guys. I'm so excited.
Y'all heard that? She's a Mikki fan.
Hey, you know Soulja Boy Telling produced this song.
Okay. Yep. How are we doing, food?
We got 5 minutes left.
Okay, ready?
We're gonna check the meatloaf in 5 minutes. I was on a plane with Dwayne. You can call me Whitley and go to hell, man. Listen, I'm the baddest in the school, the baddest in the game. Excuse me, honey, but nobody's in my lane. When you was in New York, you was a Yankee. I was with bass, I was kicking the Frankie. So cranky, give him a hanky. And mama, I'm cold, give me my blankie. Flyer than a kite, I get higher than Rapunzel. Keep a Snow White, I like to buy it by the bundle. Suck a cookie, you're doing crumb. Don't be acting like the Carter knows a dumb crumble. Cause cause I'm a stealer. All about the dealer. All the dope boys gon' feel it. Flow so slick, I need a healer. It's my MAC concealer. I be out in Queen on the back of a week. Wheelies, I'm a big deal. And I get more head than a pigtail. Than the entree. I think I have a rap for my entree. If you think it, it spit, spit, shine my shoes. Back, sign your boobs. Like a kangaroo. I'm the only thing hopping like a kangaroo.
So hold on, so I want to say this. I hear Nicki Minaj rapping. It seems like she's just talking, but like when she's rapping it. So I be wondering like how these rappers, like they're talking, they're not out of any breath.
I don't like pigs like Asalama Langham. I put them in a pan and not like Asamaya Vega. Now if you see an itty bitty piggy in the market, get a quota and a car to the market. I don't pigs like Asalama Langham. I put them in a pan and not like Asamaya Vega.
Pork steaks. Asalama Langham. Here goes some water. Here goes some water.
You tired? No, I'm fine.
Like, I don't know,
Nikki,
it's like
Lewinsky.
And like she just chilling while she rapping.
I don't even know why you girls bother at this point. Like, give it up. I win. You lose. Oh shit. Yo, I'm a bad bitch. See, I just did that without cursing. I'm proud of me.
I noticed that you.
That was hard.
One of the curse words.
That was hard. Cause it's like, you say the words. It's like you have to know the words before you can bleep them out.
I didn't know any words.
It wasn't that bad. That's a short flow. That's light work, baby. That's light work.
You know some freestyles too, ma'am.
You know Eves.
I don't really know it to me.
All right, let's check on the food. We got 2 minutes. Yeah, so what rap songs do you guys know by heart? Like, if we were to play them, which ones can you actually, like, recite off the dome?
Hello, Tracy. What's one of your little songs? I keep telling you I need to hear some. I have yet to hear anything, Tracy.
Who Shiesty? That's my dog. Who you know I'm Shiesty. Y'all, it smells so good in here. I know you can't smell anything. I feel bad for you, but boy, oh boy, it's over here hitting. Tracy said soon.
All right, Tracy.
Oh, you need this?
Yeah, I was like, my God.
Let's see. Chris said old school because I am old. Oh, Chris knows Boys in the Hood? No way. Chris, I'm going to need you to rap or freestyle Boys in the Hood. Like, this needs to happen soon. Let's see.
Because the girls in the mood is always hard.
Yeah. That's crazy. And the day you realized I was listening to Bees in the Trap. Yes, Chris.
Chris remembers.
At work, we used to have our little phones hooked up, our little headphones hooked up to the little computer desk. And yes, we was listening to that rap music. Chris knows, man. Hold on. I feel like there's a way. There we go. Let's see. If Chris wants to get on and do Boys in the Hood freestyle for us, that would be great. How's everything looking?
It looks fine.
It's a little hot.
I have to turn the green beans down.
Huh?
I just had to turn the green beans down. That's it.
Okay, cool. So are you going to plate?
It's not completely done yet. We're waiting on the
cornbread, and we're waiting on the meatloaf.
Okay.
I want them to finish together.
Okay.
So the cornbread still got at least around 10 minutes.
It's still, oh, okay.
Just in the top of it. So yeah. Still kind of whitish, you know, on top. Mm-hmm. I want to get a brown.
I'll say, well, in the meantime, Chris needs to accept this request to go on live. You got to hit an ad if you want to join us and do your Boys in the Hood freestyle.
I guess declined the live video invitation.
Chris was said, no, sir, you didn't just catch me. What about you?
What about me?
Do you want to do your freestyle?
No. That's the only song I know. I wish I knew more than that one.
I get that on
Instagram.
Oh yeah.
I don't wanna, you know, do the same route.
What freestyle I know? I know 21 questions by 50 Cent.
Oh, you do?
Have at it. Oh no, I'm gonna do it. I just did itty bitty bitty for y'all. Chris said next song. Mm-hmm. That means he don't know. He didn't know the words for real. Yes.
I don't know any song from you.
Alright, well then, quiz me on some trivia.
No, how about we play a game? For these last few minutes, we're going to play a game.
Yes.
I guess I'm thinking about would you rather.
Ooh, okay.
Would you rather this or this?
All right.
Marchette. Mm-hmm. Would you rather?
I'm scared.
Die from an earthquake? I mean, you fall into the whatever?
Okay, in a crack?
Or die from a volcano eruption.
Oh my gosh, why are these my only options?
You know, weird, and I think that's good. Okay, would you rather?
I think the volcano eruption would be a slow death because you'd be burning. But I suppose maybe the earthquake too, you'd be falling and it'd be a slow death burning too. So
would you hit, you'd die? Would you hit? You'd die quickly.
Instantly?
Yeah.
So you say, okay, so I guess, yeah, I think I would die from the earthquake.
So, also, what would you, replaying, would you rather die from an earthquake or an volcano eruption?
What about you? You answer the question.
I think I would rather die from an earthquake, falling into a crack. Because you're right, a volcano eruption, you would die too slow.
Yeah, because it's like the lava would be like all over you and just be like, ah, because it's like burning.
Exactly.
Yeah. Whereas the crack, I don't know, because maybe you'll be wedged. And everything will be on like touching you. Like if it's hot on the earth's surface, I mean underneath the earth's surface, I'm sure that maybe the walls in between, like the little crack, is probably also.
So you're gonna fall, hit.
Yes, exactly. Yes. Oh, and it's probably hot. You be like,
hopefully one will knock you out and you're done. Hopefully you're knocked out quicker and then
being knocked out over the head. It's actually getting very eerie.
Okay, I got one. Would you rather have 6 toes or 6 fingers?
Probably fingers. Because I feel like my balance is already so-so. So if I add another toe, would that throw me off balance or would it help? Maybe it would throw me off, I think. So I would say hands.
I would say toes. Because no one can see your toes all the time. But your hands, they'll all be like, something, right? Something, you know, I'm like what?
Yeah.
Or the toes, you know how your toes was.
Okay. I have a would you rather.
Okay.
Would you rather be broke for the rest of your life with a fine man, or would you rather be rich for the rest of your life and you're not working with a man that you don't find so fine?
Well, I'd rather be poor.
Forever.
With a fine man.
You're poor forever. Like, there's no job that you're going to make over, let's say, $40,000.
Okay.
Both of you. Joint income, $40,000. And that's for life. Like, no job, no entrepreneur thing, nothing. Mm-hmm. Or would you rather be with a man who's rich, mm-hmm. meaning you, even if you don't work, you're set, like, forever, but you're not as attracted to him?
I would be the rich man.
Chris said ugly dude all the way!
Yeah, I would be the rich guy. Yeah.
You would?
The rich guy.
Why? Why? Why?
Rich guy.
I mean, Chris agrees with you. He said ugly dude all the way. Is it because of the money or? Because
I get to live comfortably for the rest of my life without any issues or worries. And also you said I didn't even have to work on top of that.
Exactly.
The other one, I have to also work and him work and we're still
making just $40. But he's fine though. Mm-hmm. And he's faithful. And he's like amazing.
Hopefully, every dude will be faithful too.
See, now that's a trick, right? Isn't that kind of what we were talking about last week with Portia?
I'm hoping he is.
It's like, do you want the money and the not looks, or do you want the looks?
I'm hoping he's faithful and he got the money. I can roll out.
Okay, well, let's say he's not faithful. Let's say he's rich, you're kept, but he occasionally cheats or, you know.
So I still have him or the guy
who's fine, but you're broke. He's loyal. He doesn't cheat.
But we're broke.
Yes, but the cute dude cheats. I mean, but the ugly dude cheats. Like, he definitely, like, he gets out there occasionally. Like, he still comes home to you. He still brings the household money to you. Chris, that's still ugly.
That's what I'm saying. I'm still thinking ugly dude because if I know he's cheating, he's out there doing whatever, and I guess I'll just find me a nice looking dude and do the same.
Wow.
I can't know going into it I'm going to be broke for the rest of my life. To know that I'm going to be broke, meaning I can't do anything to make it better. To know the rest of my life I'm going to be broke no matter what. I think I got to figure something out.
And I have never. Wow.
The one thing you say, well, he's broke. Meaning we can always make money, but you said you would never.
Yeah, no jobs work out. You guys try and try. Entrepreneurs, everything
that's too
fails.
Stressful for me.
You know, you're fine.
You're fine, but we stressed. We're both stressed, but you fine. I'm like, I can't believe that.
I can't believe that you said that.
You fine, but we stressed.
I will say this: you do experience a level of comfortability when you're kept, right? Like, we don't have to work. That's some stress off of us. But if he cheats on me, I'm going to want to leave him, even though we're rich.
Well, if I'm going into it knowing he's going to, hey, understand we're going into it knowing, right? So if I'm going into it knowing he's going to cheat, I have to have in my mind, have something on the side.
Okay.
When the time comes. If I'm going into it knowingly.
So you're saying, okay, I see what you're saying. Yeah. So it would be like an understanding, right?
It's understanding.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I'm like, I know he's going to, so I might as well. I'm thinking he's the best of whatever, and then he cheats. And I'm like, dang, I didn't think. But going into it, knowing all this stuff, I just prepare myself to have something on the side.
Okay. All right. Cool. Let me even throw another wrench in there.
Okay.
Okay. Sure. Would you rather be with a homosexual man who does not want to have sex with you?
Okay.
But he wants to have sex with other people.
Okay.
And he is allowing you to have sex with other people. And he is going to take care of you. He doesn't want you to work for the rest of your life. Or would you go into a relationship with a regular guy?
Say it one more time. Would I rather what now?
You get into a relationship with or marry a gay man?
Okay.
Because maybe his parents were like, you get your inheritance money when you're rich. I don't care if you're gay. You have to get married in order for you to get your $20 million that we left you.
Okay.
And he's like, and you have to be married for like 5 years in order to get it.
Okay.
And the guy's like, look, we ain't got to ever have sex. You can have sex with your people. I have sex with my people. We have some understanding. We're trying to get this bag.
Okay.
Or would you end up with the guy who's like just a regular guy? You met a club. Everything's going really great.
Cool.
But the thing is that you can't cheat. That's what the gay man. Well, you can cheat. Obviously, you can sleep with other people.
Yeah.
But this guy who you met at the club is like, oh, no, don't do that. Give me a chance.
I'm going with the rich gay dude.
So you're not going to give yourself a chance? Maybe the guy that you met at the club.
My dude will approve of me dating the guy at the club too, right?
No, but the guy at the club won't approve of you being married to the gay guy.
I'm already married. You can't. I mean, he means
married. It's before you get into the marriage. It's like the gay guy. It's like you're dating a guy who you met at the club.
It's still the gay guy. I'm like, really? Sorry. Don't understand my situation.
So let's be clear. So you met this guy at the club, right? You guys had a regular relationship. You exchanged numbers. You texted every day. You find out that he has a really good job or whatever. He has benefits. He's a nice guy. Like, in a normal sense, you would see where this goes. All of a sudden, your gay friend comes and he comes in, he's like, we gotta get this bag, sis. $20 million.
I'm still gonna marry if it's like you said it like that, I'm still gonna marry my gay dude, my gay friend, evidently, and until my god friend I've been talking to. You say he's my man.
Right, because he's like, I can't be with somebody who is married and I just can't do it. So I'm not even going to entertain you anymore.
Well, if we're evidently, you should have already put a ring on it, or maybe your girlfriend, maybe I wouldn't have decided.
So that's it. Okay. So
that's my guy I'm talking to. I'm like,
but if you guys are exclusive and this gay guy comes up to you, would you stop
being exclusive? It's going to be a conversation. I'm saying, hey, okay.
Why can't we all get this back?
He's going to want to do it. I don't see no guy saying no.
I mean, I don't see no guy doing it, but there are some guys who are like, still, I don't mess with married women or whatever.
I'm not married, as you can see. I'm not married. But
he said that you're going to get married.
I'm going to get married.
He's like, I just can't do
this. This is for us. This is for our future.
You're going to try to convince me.
Yeah, so this is for our future. And he'll be like, you're right. He's going to do it.
Guys, yeah, I feel like guys, even Chris was saying that. Chris was like, right, see, right there. He has the little eyeballs. Yeah, I think everyone's going to chase that bag, hopefully. Yeah.
So, you guys, the food is almost done. When are you going to cornbread?
Oh, okay. Well, that shouldn't be that long.
It shouldn't. I'm going to check again.
Okay.
Oh, what? No, what? We're going to go on the temperature.
Oh, yeah. It had to be 400. So, you're going to pull out the meatloaf? But it's going to cook the meatloaf, too. Y'all, if y'all was in this kitchen, y'all could smell what we smell. It smells amazing. I wish we could give everyone a slice.
You have a knife right there on the side.
Is it hard?
I'm gonna see. I don't. It should be hard.
It doesn't look like it's hard.
I just want to see the inside. I like to see the inside. Oh, no, one down here on the thing. Okay. I want you to be a little knife. No.
Yeah, there are different sizes of them in there. Let's see. Hey, Toy! Hey, sweet girl! So, we are cooking meatloaf, and we are also discussing would you rather. And, you know, I think the would you rathers are always really good whenever you're trying to learn something about your friend or see how they think or how this conversation is going to go, because, yeah, I don't know. Yeah, I probably would do the same thing. I would probably leave my man at the club to get that man. Hey, Toy! I would probably leave that man at the club and go with my gay dude and just have other guys on the side. You know, even if I could have had this wonderful, beautiful romance with this guy I met at the club where he had like a family and kids, we'd also want that bag, you know. I guess it's almost like the instantaneous thing, right? So, like, if you won the lottery, would you take the lump sum or would you do the installment payments? That's kind of how this is. It's like, do you want the instantaneous gratification of being rich or do you want to build it over time? And it's starting to show that everybody would, you know, build it over time.
That's gonna show how broke we all are. We're all broke. Yeah.
We'll do anything for some money, child. Mm-mm-mm-mm. Except sell you guys things on this channel. So make sure you go over to YouTube and subscribe. We are not going to sell you anything. And, we're just going to have a good time. This season is going to be really fun, you guys. We have some really fun guests already lined up. We're going to start filming them pretty soon here. We are also doing skits. So I was thinking maybe instead of us just doing the skits and the episodes on YouTube, maybe we can bring the skits onto this channel on Facebook so people can still see something. But they just won't see the episodes on Facebook. You can only see the Women Talk episodes on YouTube. So that's why you can subscribe to YouTube. But we'll probably share the skits over here too. You know, for those of you guys that are just like, I don't have time for YouTube. I only have time for Facebook in my life right now. You know how people go on to those little social media detoxes and things. So yeah, we'll put at least the skits over here as well. How are the green beans?
I'm adding more salt and pepper.
Okay. That's exciting.
Let me see. Chris said, lump sum. You can get hit by a bus tomorrow. Take that money while you can. I know that's right, Chris. Yes. And also, too, they said that it's actually cheaper when it comes to taxing things out, apparently, if you take the lump sum, because if you do it in installments, they tax like each one of those little installment things. And I think that somebody did the math and they said it's cheaper, or you don't get as much if you do like that big lump sum. So, taxes, you guys. I hope you guys did your taxes, because they will come and get you. How are we on the meatloaf?
I cut it to make sure it was almost done, but we still have a little bit of time on that.
Okay. Well, guys, I think what we're going to do is we're actually going to post a picture of our plate, because we don't want to keep you guys too much longer. We've been on this live for about an hour and a half, and we really appreciate you guys coming on here and talking to us. Chris said, damn the man. Exactly! The tax man! It's like we're paying, you know, I call taxes subscriptions to a country, right? So, you know, you had these free trials for a minute, like on like CBS or like Paramount Plus, and then like after that free trial, it's like, all right, now you gotta start paying. Well, our parents already decided that we're gonna start paying taxes and subscription fees to live in the country. So the other Chris, yep. So I call it my subscription fee. When tax season comes around, I'm like, I guess it's time for me to pay my subscription fee. But yes, we're gonna take a picture. What do you think about that?
We can do that too.
Okay. So we're actually going to get off this live, you guys, and we're going to take a picture. So if you want to see the finished product, make sure that you come back. We're probably going to our story too.
Okay.
So thank you guys for coming on. And
don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Please invite friends, family, anyone.
Yes.
Because it's going to be an exciting next 2 months for us. Mm-hmm. And don't hesitate to subscribe.
Yes, and next week we're going to have some special guests in the house with us for our lives. You don't want to miss that either. We're going to turn up and have a good time. So, bye, guys. Have a good evening.
Enjoy the rest of your day.
Boom.